Today we're going to talk about how to install a DRV8825 on the Bigtree Tech SKR version 2. Now I need to point out a couple of things. So first I'm going to remove the actual USB power for a moment. That's set right here. When you're running direct power though, you're going to have to move your jumper over to the other two sets of pins. But first, what I want to explain is our steppers. We have our X stepper here, then we have our Y stepper, our Z stepper, then E0 and E1. Now, the important thing about installing these stepper drivers is that you know where the enable pin is located on both. That way you can align the pins correctly. So what I've done over here is I've flipped over another board so I can show you where the enable pins are located. So you have one right here, then you have another one over in here, 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 and here, which corresponds on the board to these corners right here. And that way you'll know where to align them. Now on the actual steppers, you'll have to actually zoom in, possibly. It's a little bit out of focus here, but the enable pin is located right here when it's flipped over. So it's actually right here, and the potentiometer gives away where it's closest to. So we need to figure out how to set up the pins for this, because the jumpers need to be set for this. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you in the web browser what that looks like. So I'll bring up the actual pinout diagram first, just so you can see it, and then we'll go from there. So here's the actual pinout diagram. As you can see, you have your stepper connection for your X, your Y, your Z. Then you have a second Z, pardon me. Then you have E0, and there should be an E1 right over here. So they do have fans mixed in between that kind of confused me. But these fans, this one looks like it's direct power, and this one is direct power as well. Then we have three fans down here that are actually runoff signals. And we're going to use that to control an actual fan cooling or fan control. So I'll show you how to set that up as well. But let's go over to the actual manual for a moment for Bigtree Tech. So inside of here, they actually have a manual on the board, and I've scrolled down from the top so you can see it, and they point out where all the fans are. They call them CNC fans, but in order to hook this up, we need to align up our jumpers for step dir mode, which is step direction mode. So in this case, our jumpers are in the wrong place because they're over on these pins over here. So we need to move them to this location. So to do that, we're gonna go back over to the workbench for a moment. I'm gonna move this out of the way, and I'm going to pick out the actual jumpers so we can set this up. So unfortunately, we gotta take all of them out. Okay, so now that they're out, we got to place them back in the right position. And as you can see, compared to the other ones, they're shifted over now. Now these might be kind of hard to get into place. You might have to wiggle them a little. Sometimes I put the connection pins too close together, so these are hard to slide in. Okay, those are done. So now we know where the enable pin is right here if we were to rotate it over. And so we're gonna line it up like so and then slide it in with a little bit of pressure. Now, what we also need to do is set up our X stepper with our NEMA stepper motor. So I'm gonna slide this over and I'm gonna connect it right here, so that we can actually, in theory, cool our actual steppers. So the cooling fan in this case is not always required for this stepper, but it's a good idea. So I'm gonna pick one of the actual controllable fans over here. So we have fan 0, 1, and 2. I'm gonna pick fan 1. and plug this in. Now the other thing we need to do is actually load firmware. So I'm going to take out the USB conversion device I have here, and I'm going to put our SD card into it right here. Once this is slipped in, we'll slip it into the computer, and we'll also move this jumper over to direct power and set that up real quick. So for direct power, what I have here are two ferrule connectors on our power supply, and they're going to go into where the power is actually the in jack that you may have seen on the actual diagram, but I'll point it out again in a second. And I've labeled these with red for voltage, and then the other one I left unmarked, and that's actually ground. So we're going to have to slide these in, and these ferrule connectors will save us a lot of headaches in the future because they keep the wires nice and crimped inside. So I'm going to tighten that down. I'm going to take the next one and do the same. I'm going to slide that in right here. Now, the power supply obviously is disconnected because this would be unsafe to do with live wires. So remember that when working on your board for safety. So now this is connected, and the power supply with the actual power not applied at the moment are connected. So once we've got that set and we've got the actual SD drive in the computer, we can go over to VS Code. So I'm going to bring up VS Code, and inside VS Code, as you can see, it doesn't have anything loaded. I did download the most current version of Marlin, which is 2.0.9.1. Now, keep in mind, Marlin's versions of software change almost monthly. So this tutorial in a couple years may be not as relevant, and that newer changes have taken place. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to actually click on the file explorer over here. I'm going to click open folder, go to my downloads folder, my Marlin folder, and my next Marlin folder. Then I'm going to say select folder, and this will bring up our environment. This may take a few moments to bring up, and once it actually does come up, what we're going to need to do is actually, first of all, right now it has the Mega 2560 from the last build. This is included in the download. We want to clean that out with the little garbage can over here. That'll take care of any kind of mess that was there from a previous build. Next, we're going to have to set our default environment, but we'll save that for last. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to Marlin Source Core Boards.h, and I'm going to search on SKR underscore V2. And you see there's an A and B version. My board is currently the B version. I just received it. So it should be safe for CMC 2208s and 2209s. So I will be doing a tutorial on that shortly. But let me first show you how to set this board up, and I'll review those interesting tidbits in the future tutorials. So I'm going to close out a core source, go to configuration.h. I'm going to search on motherboard, and inside here I'm going to paste our version of the board. I'm also going to change this to -1, and then we're going to go and search on the A4988, which is a related stepper. This does 1/16th of a step. The one we're going to be using is going to do 1/32nd of a step. So I'm going to copy this and paste it right here. Now, once that's set, the only other thing we have to worry about, we don't really have to worry about this down here until we calibrate, but this will allow us to calibrate our steps depending upon our physical configuration. These two over here are for belt driven axes, And this axis over here is actually screw driven. And then this one obviously is direct drive driven, depending upon the situation that you're using it in. So now that that's set, in order to set the cooling fan, I'm going to click on Configuration Advanced, and I'm going to search on controller space fan. And what this does, it brings up the actual option to turn on use controller fan. So I'm going to remove the comment by hitting the control and slash button. Down here, though, I do have to set a pin. So we have to go back over to the pins folder for a moment and see what that is. But I know what the actual pin is going to be in this case, and I'll show you where that is. So if we go over to the browser, and inside the actual browser, as soon as I bring it up over here, we have a tab over here for pins. So if you look down here for fan one, you can see that fan one is PB6. So now that we know what that fan is, we're going to go back over to VS Code and we're actually going to plug that in. So inside VS Code, where it says negative one, you're going to say PB6. And that sets the actual custom pin for that particular fan. Now you can change the speed. You can also set up other things, but I'm just trying to show you the simplest way to do this. So I'm going to set this to 200 just so you can see it's changeable. And what we'll do is usually it dies after 60 seconds or turns off once you go into idle mode. So I'm going to change that to 5 seconds to make the tutorial more brief instead of waiting 60 seconds. So now that that's set, we need to set up our default environment. So I'm going to go to platformio.ini and we need to set what our default environment would be. So I'm going to review this again real quick. If you go to source core boards.h over here, this tells you what your default environment is going to be, being STM32F4, and it may include the next digit after that. So let's go back over to the INI folder. This is where all our configurations are stored by chipset. And we're going to look for STM32F, which is right here. Then I'm going to search on SKR underscore V2, I think. It might be two. There we go. And so we're going to copy the very first one that we encounter. And then we're going to close out of here. We're going to go to platform.io again and paste what we just copied. So we've already cleaned the folder. So we're going to do a build, which is the checkbox down here. Now, this may take a few moments to build. And if you encounter an error while it's building, try building a second time because sometimes things build out of order that are required for the actual build. And a build is a combination of multiple compiles. That's why you're seeing compiling here. And then if you do have an error on the third try, meaning after you've done the first two, find the very first error that you encounter and fix that. And that should take care of the issue that you're encountering because all the other errors may be a cascade of errors that occur. So I'm going to click on the .pio folder. And inside here, we're going to look for our actual build in the SKR folder. And then down here, we're going to find firmware.bin. So I'm going to right click on that and I'm going to say reveal in File Explorer. And we already have the previous load over here that we did. So all we have to do is right click and send to the drive. And so I have to review this real quick so that you understand it. Firmware.cur in this case is the current firmware that had loaded last. It does say cursor file type, but that does not matter. The actual name of the file that this once was is firmware.bin. It's so it doesn't keep reloading after loading once. So it will replace the next firmware.bin with this name being your last firmware load. So let's go back over to the actual workbench for a second. I'm going to take the drive out of the computer. I'm going to then place it in here. Now we're on, I believe, direct power at this point. So I'm going to plug this in and see if it's okay. So it doesn't light up because we're on direct power, not on USB power. And then I'm going to find the power cord for the actual power supply that we're using and plug it in. So now that it's actually powered, you can see everything is functioning. The firmware just loaded with that beep. So what we're going to do next is go over to Pronterface and test this. So inside Pronterface, you're going to see the environment right now. I've had it open before we actually did the tutorial. So it might or might not be correct for COM port 4. The way to check that is to actually go over to your device manager and type device manager off your start or run prompt. And what'll happen is this will open up and you can check it. So down here it does say COM port 4, and COM port 1 is default to the computer for a desktop. So we're all set there. So I'm gonna hit connect, and currently it looks like it's not connecting. So let's figure out why that is. So I'm on COM port 1, so let's try this again. There we go. So we're all set, it's connected. So the next thing we want to do is see if things work the way that we intended. So I'm gonna change this over so you can actually see the desktop. And what's gonna happen is I'm going to hit the movement for the actual axis, and then we can watch the fan. So the fan is over here currently not moving. So we're gonna move 10 millimeters. And as you can see, the fan now is on and running. So in order to shut it off, we could either wait or we can click on motors off over here. And 5 seconds later, it should go off. So it looks like it just stopped. So if you want to turn it back on, you can always move the axis again and it'll go back on. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.